That. stabbed at the back. It's like the dark brother all over again.
We've scoured.
Any luck on your end?
Shor's beard. He's going after the eyes of the Falmer?
If he gets his hands on them, you can be certain he'll be gone for good and set up for life.
Agreed. I've spoken to Carlaya and made amends for how the guilds treated her. Quickly, we have no time to lose.
Now, lad, Carlaya said it was important.
I promise you.
Until next we meet, lad.
The time has come to decide Mercer's fate. Until a new guildmaster is chosen, the decision falls to you.
Aye, lass. And I've come to a decision.
Mercer Frey tried to kill both of you. He betrayed the guild, murdered Gallus, and made us question our future. He needs to die.
Mercer is a nightingale, an agent of Nocturnal.
Then it's all true. Everything I heard in the stories. The Nightingales, their allegiance to Nocturnal, and the Twilight Sepulchre.
Yes. That's why we need to prepare ourselves and meet Mercer on equal footing. Just outside of Riften, beyond the southeast gate, is a small path cut up the mountainside. At the end of that path is a clearing, and an old standing stone. I'd ask you both to meet me there.
I have some preparations of my own to make. I'll meet you at the stone.
Good, you're back. Well, what did Mallory have to say?
The Elder Council?
Oh, now that explains quite a bit. Motier, you naughty, naughty boy. Was Mallory willing to buy the amulet? Splendid. Then we're ready to begin. But by Sithis, I hope I'm making the right choice here. The sealed letter you delivered to me was mysteriously unsealed upon its arrival. I can only assume you've read its contents. Sloppy. But moving on to business. As you probably already know from reading the letter, you're going to a wedding. Well, more like the public reception. Oh, yes. You've got to kill the bride. And they say romance is dead. Her name is Vittoria Vici. The wedding is being held in that city, at the Temple of the Divines. Vici is likely to address her guests frequently, as is the wedding custom. Kill her when she does that, and I promise you a significant bonus. Now go, and give my best to the bride. Represent us well, brother.
Oh, hello.
You should see me when you get bored, stranger.
Heard they're reforming the Dawn Guard. Vampire hunters or something in the old fort near Riften.
Typical Imperial rot. You speak of Skyrim like you know the land.
No, it's people.
You're from Cyrodiil. You know nothing about us. Nothing!
Oh, I know enough. I know those troublemaking Stormcloaks refuse to submit to Imperial authority. Such seditious behavior. Why, it's treason!
And when the elves marched into your beloved... Cyrodiil, and everyone took up arms against them? Wasn't that treason? Against the Dominion, huh?
Why, that's not the same thing at all. The Dominion were invaders, conquerors. We had to fight them to preserve our own way of life.
My point exactly.
Victoria!
Please, someone do something!
Over here!
The bride has been murdered! Somebody help!
Come on now. I want those arrows dead set. The lives of the fellow soldiers are counted.
Honored guests, are you all enjoying yourselves? Please, eat, drink, and make merry on this most happy of days.
Someday soon, you
in this courtyard, there are no
today?
Stormcloaks. There are no Imperials. There are only people come to celebrate a union of two souls. So make merry. You have all helped to make this a truly extraordinary wedding. All of my dreams have come true, so thank you. Thank you all.
Someone do something.
What? You've been spotted. Victoria! No!
I thank you all again for making this the best wedding a woman could ask for.
Vittoria! Oh!
The bride has been murdered! Somebody help!
The news is everywhere. Vittoria Vici, the Emperor's cousin, butchered at her own wedding. With Vici's murder, you've started us down a path the Dark Brotherhood hasn't traveled in centuries. And now your reward. A unique spell to summon a legend of the Dark Brotherhood. Ah, and of course, a bonus for killing Vici while she addressed her guests as instructed. Gold. Now then. Time to proceed to the next stage of the plan. Go and speak with Gabriella. She's been helping me arrange your next contract.
Ah, you're back. It was good to fight alongside you. I'm sure people won't be forgetting that wedding anytime soon.
Dear brother, I've been waiting for you. With the Emperor's arrival in Skyrim now a certainty, his security service, the Penitus Oculatus, will need to begin its preparations immediately. Security is being handled by a Commander Morrow. You are to slay the Commander's son, Gaius Morrow, and once he is dead, plant false evidence on his body, implicating him in a plot to kill the Emperor. He is set to leave the Penitus Oculatus outpost at Dragonbridge. Go there now. Observe Gaius Morrow's departure and follow him. Once he's dead, plant the incriminating letter on his body. Oh, and one final thing. To earn your bonus, do not kill Gaius Morrow in Dragonbridge or on the road. There, the body will be discovered quickly. Do that, and Astrid has authorized me to grant you a rather unique bonus. Olava is an old and dear friend, and a powerful seer. The token entitles you to a reading of your future. It's an opportunity one should not pass up.
Leave me alone.
I don't have time for this foolishness.
Yes?
You won't have to give up. Brother, I think she's telling the truth.
I'm not going. I'll back off before I do something drastic.
She doesn't have the scar.
What? Oh, you're right.
We've made a mistake. Now move along before that mouth of yours gets you into trouble.
I know you will. All the same, remember everything I said.
Stay alert. Stop right there.
Get to the cities. Make your observations.
Man, move on.
I understand.
Here.
Oh, Fida. I may travel alone, but you know I carry you always in my heart. I'll see you soon. Trust me, we have nothing to say to one another. Citizen?
A little busy at the moment.
I've got all sorts of errands to run.
True, I may look the part of dashing swordsman, but I prefer the art of wit.
I'm telling you, Ulfric's planning an attack on Whiterun.
He'd be insane to try. He doesn't have the men.
That's not what my scouts report.
What was that?
Every day, more joined him.
Ah,
Riften, Dawnstar, and Winterhold support him.
It's not a cause. It's a...
Call it whatever you like, General. The man's going to try to take White.
Ah, at last. I've been anxiously awaiting your return. Yes, I know. But you should know that we have a more pressing matter to deal with. It's... Cicero. There's been an incident. You should proceed into the sanctuary. I'll let Astrid explain.
try to relax, Mizara. Let the elixir do its work. You'll feel better shortly.
Thank you, dear. You are most kind. The jester's cut feels as bad as it looks, I'm afraid.
Damn it. This never should have happened. We knew better. We knew better, and still we let our guards down. Ugh!
I'll admit, even I'm having a hard time disagreeing with you.
Marrow is dead, I know. But we've got bigger problems right now. The fool went absolutely berserk. He wounded Vizara, tried to kill me, and then he fled. I knew that lunatic couldn't be trusted.
Oh, it's true, I'm afraid. Cicero was a little whirlwind, slashing this way and that. It would have been funny if he weren't trying to murder us all.
Don't forget the ranting and raving about the Night Mother, how she was the true leader of the Dark Brotherhood, and Astrid was just a pretender.
Look, we've got to deal with this situation. You've got to deal with this situation. I want you to find that miserable little fool and end his life. But first, find my husband. After the attack, Arnbjorn flew into a rage. Search Cicero's room. Let me know the minute you find something. I've got to see to Vizara and call... Look, we've got to deal with this situation.
Bested by
you've
a fool.
Got to deal with this situation.
Now.
you found something? Good. Good. The Dawnstar Sanctuary? Never mind, it doesn't matter. Every moment counts. So I want you to take my horse, find Arnbjorn, and then send that jester's twisted little soul to the void, in as many pieces as possible. No, nothing. Well, if I'm being honest, I haven't exactly been discreet lately in expressing my frustration with this whole situation. Obeying the Night Mother, you being the listener, it's ridiculous. No offense. Cicero may have overheard me talking to one of the others about the Night Mother, but to go this far, to attempt to murder the leader of a sanctuary, Cicero must pay with his life. Oh, it's ancient. If you say Cicero has gone there, it stands to reason that he's familiar with the place. Tread carefully. Damnable jester.